In the first episode of the Dictionary of Applied Economics, the term economics itself was defined briefly. I want to step back for a couple of minutes and say a bit more about what economics is. There are many different ways that people understand economics, and many of these are off the mark or misleading. So, shall we start with the dictionary definition? Absolutely not. The definition of economics that you'll find in a dictionary is outdated and unhelpful. In fact, I think it does more harm than good. And let's also set aside macroeconomics, the kind of economics that tries to predict the growth of the whole economy and unemployment and inflation and what we should do with the money supply. There's a lot of voodoo economics there. The best way to understand the economics that we rely on for applied economics work is to think of it as a behavioral science, a way to understand people. We study their preferences and values, their decisions and actions, how they make trade-offs. We have theory, we test hypotheses, and try to validate what we think we understand about why people do what they do. We look at settings where people compete, where they cooperate, and study why each works in some situations, but not in others. Economics is a very general social science. With it, we can understand how people spend their time, how they use land or other resources, the choices they make about where to live and what careers to choose. We can understand people's actions individually, in families, in small groups, why they start a business or operate a farm. And we can also look at the behavior of people in cities and towns, states and nations, and the international community. There are so many aspects of economics. In fact, within the economics profession, there are about 850 subject areas. By studying how people behave and observing what they value, our economic tools of analysis can provide insight and information that can help policymakers make better decisions for society, such as laws, regulations, and policies, or international treaties. You see, people are part of a system, one that has ecological, legal, and technological dimensions. We study how they behave within that system and how their behavior affects that system. And often, with that perspective, we can understand what kinds of actions or policies that tweak parts of that system might help solve problems facing society.